Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Today's question sent in by Gopal. Gopal wants to ask about rounding. He has these two numbers and wants to be able to round to this desired result. Now, it looks like he always wants to round up to the next highest integer. Let's just talk about rounding in general first. Most of the time, rounding is done with the round function. Equal round, we specify the number, and then how many digits we want to round to. So, if I wanted to round to the nearest penny, I would say that I wanted to go to two decimal places. And that will round it off. Now, watch out, because it happened to be 90, it didn't give us enough decimals, but you'll see that even if I increase, it is, in fact, rounding that off correctly. Now, what if we need to round to the nearest $10? Well, then, equal round that number, and you can say negative one digits. That will round up to the nearest 10. So, round is great for rounding the nearest 10, 100, 1,000, and so on. Another kind of tricky one is if we need to round to the nearest nickel. There's something called MROUND. M stands for multiple. So, this number rounded off the nearest 0.05. Close paren, and that will round off to the nearest nickel. But for Gopal's question, where we always want to round up, there is a pair of functions. Round down and round up. Round up and that number to the nearest zero digit. And you see that it rounds up in that case and rounds up in that case, even though it's just 0.01 as the decimal. So there you have it. Several different options for rounding, whether you need to round to the nearest penny, nearest $10. Strange things like rounding off to a nickel or always rounding in one certain direction. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.